When I was watching War Horse, there were a few people right behind me who were talking so much during some scenes, and I was getting so pissed off, I wanted to say this to them. Can you please be quiet? Do you realize what movie we're watching? We're watching a Steven Spielberg film. And do you know who Steven Spielberg is? I'm gonna tell you right now. He is one of the greatest filmmakers of all time. For example, Indiana Jones, Jaws, Close Encounters of the Third Kind, Schindler's List, Saving Private Ryan, and so many much more movies. If you talk during some scenes, you are pretty much essentially being a disgrace to Steven Spielberg. Can you please shut up and watch the movie? God darn it! War Horse. I've been looking forward to this movie for so long. It's been about a year and a half or a year. It has been easily my most anticipated movie, or my second most anticipated movie of 2011 after Summer. And was this movie worth the wait? Yes. War Horse is pretty much about a boy named Albert who has this horse. He trained him. He took care of him. Unfortunately, something bad happens. The horse gets sold for the army for World War One, since World War One is starting now. So now the horse goes to these different kinds of areas. It's pretty much his perspective on going to these different armies, different people. At the same time, Albert, the boy, looks for him. The movie is directed by the one and only Steven Spielberg. He directs this movie so well, and since he directed a lot of movies of like World War One kind of period pieces, for example, Schindler's List, Saving Private Ryan, you know, he's pretty much the king of these kind of movies. He's such a good storyteller. I love the way he tells stories. The cinematography is beautifully shot. And if you don't know, the person who did the cinematography is pretty much a longtime collaborator with Steven Spielberg. I love the angles in this movie. Like, there's some angles that are very, like, interesting. And also his continuous shots. Master shots like this, pretty much one take. It's beautiful to look at. It is magnificent. The cinematography, one of the best of the year. The story is very interesting. It's very engaging. And there were some parts when I was like, oh, what's gonna happen next? What's gonna happen next? The acting was pretty good, mostly. Emily Watson, who plays the boy's mother, she was very good. Jeremy Irvine, who plays Albert, the main boy, I thought he was kind of so-so. In the beginning, I thought I didn't really buy him. But eventually in the movie, I actually thought his performance was better. Tom Hiddleston, who is Loki and Thor and also Midnight in Paris. You know, he was fantastic. I think he did the best performance in this movie. The music score is so beautiful, and of course, it's John Williams. The thing with music composing is that, you know, like when you have a song, it just can't be in the scene just because it's gonna be epic. It needs to work in the scene. It needs to have, it's supposed to enhance the scene, and that's what John Williams does. It's beautiful music score, one of the best of the year. When there are scenes when they have, like, a lot of the war fighting and a lot of like beautiful scenes with the music score, it is poetry on screen. When it comes to films that involve war or animals, you really need to have like a really powerful story. It needs to be very powerful, very moving, very emotional. This movie is so powerful, it is so emotional, and I'm not kidding, I actually cried. There was one scene that was so powerful and so emotional that this was my reaction in the theater. The movie takes place in World War One, and like the movie looks really good. Like the set pieces are amazing, the art direction, the costumes, the war sequences are beautiful to look at. It's awesome, it's mind-blowing, because you know, since Steven Spielberg did Saving Private Ryan, a lot of war movies, you know, he really knows how to make like war sequences very real. Even if I really like this movie, there are a couple problems with this movie that really bugged me. Some of the dialogue that was performed by some of these actors, it didn't really fit well with the scene, because there were some scenes that were very, it was very kind of emotional, and there was like this random dialogue or kind of line that they said, I was like, what? Like, really? I didn't mind the length of this movie. It's 2 hours and 20 minutes. I actually like that. It's a very long movie. But honestly, there were some scenes that could have been a lot shorter. If they cut like the whole movie out by like 5 minutes, the narrative momentum would have been much better. Since there were some scenes that were kind of, I lost interest. It kind of lost my engagement of the whole time. So yeah guys, overall, War Horse is an extremely good movie. What makes this movie so good is that there's an emotional side to it. You actually get into the characters, you actually care for them. And that is how you make a movie. You need an emotional punch. And that's what this movie has. Emotion! 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 I'm going to give Warhorse a really high 8.5 out of 10. So I hope you guys enjoyed my review of Warhorse. Comment, rate, subscribe if you want. And until next time, guys, I'm Ryan. See you guys later.